Let's solve together our first related rates problem. The radius of a particular circle increases at 1 millimeter each second. As a result, its area changes. How fast is its area changing when its radius is 20 millimeters? We'll use our four-step problem-solving strategy for related rates problems to tackle this, since it works every time. We first draw a picture of the physical situation, which is a circle, with a radius that we'll label r. The problem gives us the rate at which the radius increases. That rate is dr dt, the rate at which the radius r changes with respect to time t. And that equals 1 millimeter per second. The problem asks us something about the circle's area that we'll label A. The problem wants us to find how fast that area is changing, which means we need to find the rate dA dt, the rate at which the area A changes with respect to time t. We want that rate at a particular instant when r equals 20 millimeters. So we're given the value of dr dt, and we're asked something about dA dt. We thus need to find the relation between those two quantities. Now clearly, as the circle's radius increases, its area increases as well. Furthermore, if the radius increases more quickly, then the circle's area also increases more quickly. The rate at which the area A changes, dA dt, is thus somehow related to the rate at which the radius r changes, dr dt. Our job is to find the exact relationship between those two quantities. In order to find that relation, we first back up a step and need to find a relation between A and r. That takes us to the second step of our problem-solving strategy, to write an equation that relates the quantity of interest, in this case, between A and R. In any related rates problem that you solve, you'll use one of four approaches that you need to know to complete this step. We cover each of them in our free materials on our website. This problem uses the easiest of those four approaches, a geometric fact that you either know or can look up. Here, we just need the formula for the area of a circle in terms of its radius, a equals pi r squared. Now, a common mistake at this point is to substitute 20 millimeters for r, but you can't proceed correctly if you do that. Instead, because the value of the radius changes as the circle grows, we have to leave r as a variable for now. We'll substitute r equals 20 millimeters at the end of our solution. The equation a equals pi r squared actually completes the second step of our problem-solving strategy, since that's the relation between a and r that we need. So we can move to the third step and take the derivative with respect to time of both sides of our equation, remembering the chain rule when we do so. The derivative of the left-hand side of the equation gives us d dt of the circle's area a, and that equals the derivative of the right side of the equation, d dt of pi r squared. On the left-hand side, the derivative with respect to time t of the area A is the rate dA dt. On the right-hand side of the equation, we can pull pi out, since that's a constant, and we're left with the derivative d dt of r squared, and that derivative is 2r times dr dt. The 2r part is probably clear to you, since we started with r squared. If you wonder why the dr dt term is there, then please watch the brief discussion in the separate video, because that term is very important when you're working through a related rates problem, and it's frequently unfamiliar to students who are just starting out. And without it, you can't relate dA dt to dr dt, and so you can't proceed. Continuing on here, we can rearrange the terms on the right-hand side of the equation, so we have dA dt equals 2 pi r times dr dt. And that completes the third step of our problem-solving strategy, since we now have the relation between dA dt and dr dt that we need. The fourth and final step of our strategy is then simply to solve for the quantity we're after. Remember that we want the value of dA dt, which we just found equals 2 pi r times dr dt. So we have dA dt equals 2 pi times r, and we're interested in the moment when r equals 20 millimeters, so we can make that substitution, and then times dr dt, which equals 1 millimeter per second. And now just a little math. 2 pi times 20 times 1 is 40 pi. And the units are millimeters squared per second, which are just the units we expect for the rate of change of an area, which should be millimeters squared, with respect to time, which is measured in seconds. And that's it. Our final answer is 40 pi millimeters squared per second. Here's a summary screen of the 4 steps that we used to solve this problem, so you can screen grab it if you'd like. Remember that we use these same 4 steps to solve every related rates problem that we encounter, and you can too. You can download the problem-solving strategy for yourself and see a lot more calculus problems, each with a completely worked out solution, at our website, mathino.com. Please also subscribe to our YouTube channel, and you can immediately go to a video solution of another related rates problem that illustrates a different approach that you need to know in step 2. For now, please let us know the questions you have or any suggestions. We'll do our best to help.